Are you still looking for gifts for that special somebody?
Well, I've got 10 DIY gifts that I'm going to show you in the next 10 days. Here's the first one. This is exactly how you do it. What you need, ball mason jars or any type of mason jars that you can find. You can usually find them at your dollar store. You can find them at Walmart, Dollar General, Dollar Family Dollar, anywhere you can find these. Most of the time, they're laying in your garage, underneath your sink, cabinets. So grab some of these and come back. If you know somebody who is gluten intolerant and you want to make this type of a gift for them and you don't want to have to expend all the extra money on gluten-free flours and all these other extra things, you can buy a box of gluten-free cake mix or brownie mix and do the same thing that I'm doing. So you want to cut the bag and put it in there. Now this has chocolate chips in it, so I don't have to add chocolate chips to this mix. Add some walnuts. When you add them, you want to make them look pretty. So you basically want to layer them so that you can see them on the side. It's basically about a half a cup. You add any type of candy that you want on top. I chose Hershey Kisses. Now when they bake it, I'm gonna put a little card on the side of here. When I show you the decorations, I'll explain it better, with all the cooking instructions on how to make this and what to do with these Hershey Kisses. This is another one that I made with vanilla cake mix. I did about a cup of the cake mix and I added walnuts on here. Next, I'm going to add chocolate chips, and that is done. I'm going to show you how to decorate them and how to put the cooking instructions on there so that you can give them away as a gift. Next, I'm going to show you guys two separate ways that you can decorate these, either with a square or a big piece of fabric. You just screw it on like that, or obviously this is going to have to be cut. You have your husband help you like mine is right now. You take a piece of ribbon and you tie a knot, and then you can cut your fabric to whatever size you want. What I did was I took some extra Christmas cards, I cut them, and I put the instructions on the inside of how to bake them. Whether you take them to a Christmas party, you give them to a teacher as a gift, a friend, a neighbor, you've got two Christmas gifts for under $4. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to us.